if you're going to bring somebody else in, they're not going to see how they make plays in your offense based on the way you've laid out the last year and a half. It's going to be hard to get better. Now, he's going to continue to get better, but just him.
I just
to some extent, unless he's willing to throw balls and work in practice to for him to sometimes lose, to go outside of his process for the overall well-being of the group's process. Then I need Ryan Grant, Josh Doctson, and Jordan Reed, and Jamison Crowder to go through their process, and you're not helping them. So should I put Colt in? Should I run a Kirk period so you can get your process, and should I run another period so I can just let Colt throw it down to them so they can get their
go
process?
Go ahead and do that.
We'll
and
let our guy throw our other guy throw a bunch of balls so we can get contested passes, and we can try to separate in one-on-one coverage. Should I do that?
When we're done.
And what happens when Colt completes all these balls and you throw all these checkdowns in practice? And everybody else in the locker room says,
he's not
let this guy do it. But the game plan that also says, hey, when you got two corners on the outside and a vertical down the middle of the field, if you got cover two, throw it at the head of the Mike linebacker who's dropping the middle. And Jason Campbell never throws it to me one time in two in two seasons, and Todd Collins comes in for one game, and I go down the middle, and oh, my God, it's right at the back of the linebacker's head, and I catch it, and I say to myself, we've been coaching that for a year and a half, and my God, I finally caught it. This really works. This offense that we're practicing and installing and we're talking about and showing clips of actually works. It's just the quarterback finally threw one.